Hello dear students, now we have the major topic of this chapter, that is some important methods of methods in psychology, some important methods in psychology. And in this video we will learn the first method, that is observational method. So in the previous section we learned about various types of data that we collect in psychological inquiry, but collecting all these various data is not possible through a single method of inquiry. So here we will study some various methods of collection of data. So the first method is observational method. As I told you, in this video we will be discussing the observational method. Observation is a powerful tool of psychological inquiry. It is an effective way of describing behavior. It is a powerful tool in psychological inquiry, and it is the best effective way of describing behavior. And scientific observation differs from day-to-day observation in many aspects. Scientific observation differs from day-to-day observation. So suppose you are observing me. So what is the difference between this observation and a scientific observation? That is what we are going to understand here. So a scientific observation involves three stages. A scientific observation involves three stages, that are selection. The first one is selection, second one is recording, and the third one is analysis of the data. Selection, recording, analysis of the data are the three stages which involves in the scientific observation. Let us see one by one. First one, selection. So to observe scientifically, we need to know what to observe, and we need to identify, we need to differentiate we need to differentiate the relevant behavior and the irrelevant behavior, and we need to find the, or we need to focus on the important behavior that we need for the research point of view. So we need to, in the selection stage, we need to know what we are going to observe. What we are going to observe, then we need to differentiate irrelevant and relevant behavior. So the observer will not observe the all the behaviors that happen. He will only observe the particular behavior that he focus on in his research. So he'll observe only that particular behavior, not all the behaviors. Okay, so that is there in the selection process, selecting the particular behavior which is needed for his research. That is the first stage in the scientific observation. Now, the second stage is recording. So we need to record the behavior. We selected the behavior. Now we need to record the what is we are observing. So that we need to record here. So that is the second stage. So we need to record how many times a particular behavior occurs. That we need to record here. How many times a particular behavior occurs, and then what is the physical setting or in which settings the behavior is occurs, in which settings the behavior occurs. So for here, for how many times the behavior occurs, we can use we can use tally marks to record the times of the number of behavior, number of times of behavior it occurs, and we can also use the video recording, and we can use photographs. So all these methods we can use for the recording of data. Then we can collect the data here, video recording, then photographs. So using this techniques we can record the data. Okay, so we selected the data here in the first stage, and then the selected data that we are going to observe, we will record here the how many times that particular behavior occurred, or in which settings it's occurring, or we can use this video recording or photograph for recording the data. And now the third stage is analysis of the data. So after recording the data, we need to analyze the data, and we need to bring some meanings of that particular data. So to derive some meanings out of it, out of the collected or recorded data. So these are the three stages which involves in the scientific observation. First one, selection; second one, recording; and as third one, analysis of the data. In the selection process, we will observe only the particular behavior which we are going to focus on in the research. Now in the second stage, the recording, will see which settings or how many times the behavior occurs, will record it. Now in the third stage, in the analysis of the data, the recorded data will be, we need to analyze the data, and will bring some meanings out of it. So these are the three stages which involves in the scientific observation. Now the next topic we are going to discuss in this observational method is types of observation. First one, naturalistic versus controlled observation, and the second one, non-participant versus participant observation. Now let us see the first one, naturalistic observation. Here the observation occurs in the real setting where that the person being observed. So it happens in the real setting where the person being observed, real setting. Suppose in a classroom, for example, classroom behavior, a supervisor comes to observe your classroom activities, then that is in the real setting, that is naturalistic, no artificiality here, because the person is not bothered that is being observed. So there won't be any manipulations, and there won't be any changes in his behavior. He will behave as he is. Okay, so there won't be any change in the behavior, and he don't know that he is being observed. So that is the naturalistic observation. It happens in the real settings, no artificiality. So this is the first type, that is naturalistic observation. Second one is controlled observation. Here the observation happens in a controlled setting. And here the observation will be under the control of the researcher, and the researcher will guide you or tell you what you need to do. So your behavior will depend upon the input that you have been given by the researcher. Okay, so it is under the controlled setting. For example, a laboratory laboratory setting observation is made. he'll guide you. The observation or the observer will guide you what to do, how to behave. So it's under the controlled setting. And then here the participant will be conscious, because he knows that he need to behave in a way where the observer expects him to do. So his behavior will according to what the researcher expects him to do. So it is, that is the controlled observation. It will be under the controlled setting. The participant will be aware of it. He'll be conscious, and his behavior will be according to the input which is being given by the observer. That is controlled observation. So naturalistic versus observation versus controlled observation. Here natural setting will be in real setting, whereas in controlled observation, the observation happens in a controlled setting. And here no artificiality will be there, no modification of behavior will be there. But here in naturalistic observation, the participant will be knowing that he is being observed, he will be conscious of that. Whereas in controlled observation, he won't be conscious. Here the participant will be conscious. That is naturalistic versus controlled observation. Next one is non-participant. Okay, participant observation. Here the researcher or observer becomes the member of the group which he wants to observe. He'll become the part of that group which he wants to observe. So first of all, he need to make a rapport with that particular group which he is going to observe. He'll make a rapport. For that, he is going to observe the day-to-day activities of a tribal community in a rural area. Then he need to go and stay with those people in their village, the area where they live in. He will stay with them, and he needs to communicate with those people. And for that, for communicating with them, he needs to know their language. Then he need to know their language, and he will communicate with them. And while mingling with them, he will observe. That is participant observation. He will become the member of the group. So that is participant observation. Next one is non-participant observation. In non-participant observation, it doesn't need to be a part of that group. The observer will not be join as a part of that group. He is going to observe, but he will observe from outside. He will observe from outside. For example, this classroom activities, he don't need to join the classroom. He don't need to join there, but he can install a camera, and then he can observe the participants. So here the participants will not be conscious. They may not know that they are being observed. Here they won't be knowing. Whereas in participant observation, the participants, they will be aware of that they are being observed by this person who joined the group. So the behavior can be modified here, or maybe for manipulations will be here in participant observation. But in non-participant observation, they won't be aware of that they are being observed. So that is participant and observation versus non-participant observation. Naturalistic observation, controlled observation. So I hope you understood. The topic is clear for you. That is all about the observation method. We'll summarize. Observation. is a powerful tool of inquiry, is effective way of describing behavior. Scientific observation is different from day-to-day observations, and in scientific observation there are three stages involved. First one, selection, and it involves the observer will observe only the particular behavior we want to study, and here he will select the behavior. Okay, and here in the second stage, he will record the selected behavior. He will observe and then he will record in many ways. And now in the third stage, he will analysis of the data. He will derive some meaning out of it, what he's recorded. And next is types of observation: naturalistic versus control observation. And in naturalistic observation, it just happens in a real setting, whereas in control observation happens in a control setting. No artificiality here, it will be modified. And then participant versus non-participant observation, it will become the member of the group and will study, or he will observe the group. And then non-participant observation, he doesn't need to be a part of that group, he will observe from outside, he can install a camera or something like that for the observation, and the participant won't be aware of that they are being observed. But in this case, in participant observation, they will be aware of, they will be conscious, so some modifications of behavior can be happened there. So that's it. Thank you.